Dear Margaret, I'm a man who was well before this fatal loss. And the day after the pawn was captured, my band entered the town and played through some of the streets. The town was deserted when we entered. When we left 9 days later, it was still there. The buildings were all blown down, very few people standing. Moving pictures were taken of us as we were playing through the streets, so if you see any such, you will know it is us. We feel it was an honour to be the first band there. 9 days later, when we were going back for a rest with the brigade, we passed a half a dozen bands, and they thought they were the first on the scene. But their lips dropped when they saw us on the back. Your loving husband, Arthur.
Thank you.
side by side with our king from over sea. We have fought and we have tested one another, and enrolled among the brotherhood are we. There was never post of danger that we sought in the fighting through the fire and through the flood. There was never prize so costly, but we bought it, though we paid for its purchase with our blood. Was there any road too rough for us to travel? Was there any path too far for us to tread? You can track us by the blood prints on the gravel, on the roads that we milestone with our dead. And for you, oh, our young and anxious mother, oh, your great gains keeping watch and ward, neither fearing nor despising any other, we will hold your possessions with the sword.
So what if this worst state, die.
Thank you.
mother, father, else in life. As we're going into action tonight, at an enemy, I'm just writing to let you know that I'm still well at time of writing. But in case anything happens to me in the attack, don't worry over me. Please.
What passing bells for these who die as cattle? Only the monstrous anger of the guns. Only the stuttering rifles' rapid rattle can patter out their hasty horizons. No mockeries now for them. No prayers, nor bells, nor any voice of mourning save the choirs, the shrill, demented choirs of waving shells, and bugles calling for them from sad shires. What candles may be held to speed them all? None hands and boys in their eyes shall shine the holy glimmers of goodbyes. The pallor of girls of brow shall be their pall. Their flowers, the tenderness of patient minds, and each slow dusk, a drawing down of blinds.
Thank you.
son Leslie, was killed in action during our last engagement with the enemy. His place was usually on headquarters, but NCOs were needed in the front line, and so he was placed in charge of a post in front of Earlville Hall, a place our battalion captured during the engagement. While in charge, he was struck by a shell and killed instantaneously. Two of his comrades, Corporal W. Dunn and Private R.C. Allen, buried him, and tomorrow afternoon, they are taking up a cross to mark the spot. There was a postcard photo of your son in his pocket, which Private Allen desired to have. So I gave it to him, as he was very much attached to his comrade. And I judge that your son would have sent you copies of it before. I can only close by expressing the hope that the God of all comfort will soften the sorrow of your loss. Sincerely yours, William H. Sherman, Chaplain, 8th Battalion.
Thank you.